I'm finna save you some time. I'm finna save you some time.
How do I make it stop?
Listen, creators, oftentimes you are creating videos and you need to just clip a piece of audio out of a video clip that you can use for a video that you're editing. Oftentimes, I record something on my phone and maybe the iPhone microphone was all I had at the moment. The audio is a little bit, let's call it busted, and I want to clean it up a little bit. I can send that audio file to Auphonic, even on my phone, to get it nice and clean, and then I'll pull it down. I can stick it back together with, say, something like CapCut or whatever you edit within your phone, and then now I can publish that reel to, say, social media. Oftentimes, I just want to do something where I just have the audio itself, and I'm going to add a piece of music to it, but I want something clean. So again, lots of reasons why you could do it, but I'm going to show you how to do this. Now, we are going to build this little shortcut on your Mac with an app called Shortcuts.
That's cute.
This is going to be done on your Mac, but watch, because of iCloud, it will sync over to your phone and it should still work flawlessly, provided I don't screw something up. Now, not a Shortcuts expert, but I tend to dabble because I like Shortcuts. It just saves you a lot of time. First thing we're going to do is we're going to jump over to Finder and let you see what I'm speaking about. If you don't see this icon view the way that I have it, cool, that's you. You can press on the command 1, command 2, 3, 4, and that will jump you between the various views of macOS. And then I want to go back to my command 1. What I want to do is hit command shift P to see the preview, and then I'm going to embiggen this up. Now, here is a common clip you see in your little YouTube videos, and that's this.
A few moments later.
Right? That always pops up. You hear that all the time. But I don't want the video part. I just want the sound, because maybe I want to add that sound to my Rodecaster Pro. So I'm going to show you a little trick. Normally on the Finder, you can click down here and you can go to Customize, and you would be able to trigger one of your shortcuts. Normally, you can just come down here to the little more section and you can click the three little ellipses and you'll see a shortcut that you can add. So what we're going to do is we're going to go generate that shortcut. Let's pop over to the Shortcuts app, and then in the Shortcuts app at the very top, we're going to press on the plus sign. Say that 87 times real fast. Now, right here, we're going to name this guy Bust Out. It's because I already have one that I created years ago called Extract Audio, and I don't want to mess that one up. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we want to grab a media input, and we want to grab it from the share sheet. So what we're going to do is click on this little information guy here, and we want to check box show and share sheet, receive what's on screen, use the quick actions, and then select all of these guys. Okay, that's all we want. We want to check all of those. These guys are what we're going to do. Now, we're going to go back to this little sparkly box section over here, and we're going to click on that. And then from here, we want to go and type in the word encode, because it's easier than searching for it. E-N-C-O-D-E. And we want to encode media. We're going to drop this right betwixt the first one and the second one. So what this is telling Shortcuts app to do is to take all of this stuff from up here and bring it down into the Shortcuts input. Now, I'm going to click on show more, and I'm going to do audio only, and I'm going to leave it at M4A. You could use AIFF if you wanted to, but for most of us Mac people, and for simplicity and compatibility, we're just going to leave it at M4A. We're not going to touch the speed, although you could if you wish. You could speed it up, make it slower, whatever. I'm going to leave it just like such. And then, before we do that, I want to go back to one step. I don't really need all of these other media types, so I'm going to turn off everything except for media. I don't think I need the rest of these for this particular situation. And unfortunately, I don't know of a way to make it do this quicker. I'm sure there is, right? All I really need is media. Okay, so we're going to call it that. It's going to say media and apps at the top, but it really is just receiving the media. I thought before you used to be able to just edit that. Let me see what happens if I type media and just select it. Yeah, it still says media apps. Who cares? We're going to leave it like that. All right, maybe that's something that happened when Sequoia came alive. Now, we're going to add one more piece. We want to come over here and we want to type in save. And we're going to grab the second one here, blue, and we're going to drop it betwixt and between here. And it's just going to save the encoded media. When we click on show more, all I care about is that it asks me where to save the file. That, my friends, is the whole entire shoot and match. Now, you could click on the little icon here, give it a particular color to which you like, and then like change this guy. I'm going to use a little speaker icon because it makes more sense to my head. So we're going to have the little speaker icon right there. And then I'm going to go ahead and close this guy. And so now we have us a new guy. It's going to show up on the side on the share sheets. And we have one that is called Bust Out. So if we jump back over to Finder now, and then we look at this video clippy here. If I click on more, you'll see Bust Out is right there, right? But all we're going to concern here is we're going to click on this guy. We're going to press this little guy and we're going to say Bust Out. And then it's going to ask me where to save it. I'm going to say the same folder, press open. And then at the very top, if I scroll up, come on, mouse, don't be funny. Of course, my mouth is being funny. There it is right here at the top.
A few moments later.
Let's do another one real quick. I'm going to click on this guy and then click on more and say bust out. It's going to ask me where to want to save it. If I scroll to the top, there it is.
Till it's cool, just cool, into the mouth.
This is Editor Doc here, and I first set this up. I had the stop action added, which is unnecessary. So that was causing me to get the same file twice. And now I'm going to show you the finished output because I went in and deleted that last action. So when you first set it up, I believe it automatically put that for me, which is why I had it twice. But you don't need this end portion. So you could take it out. I think you could have skipped the save encoded step, but I wanted to always ask me where it's going. So I'd rather put that there so I know where it's going and then delete the bottom. So you'll see I'm going to go over it again. This is what your final output will look like. Now back to your regularly scheduled Docember tips. It's still there. I only needed one. I had it saving twice.
A few moments later.
There you go. So that is all you need to do. Just so you can see that again, if you want to screenshot that so that you can have it, I can put a link to a screenshot in the bottom below. But basically what you're looking for is to receive this data, drop it on the share sheet, and you're good to go. Now, like I said, iOS and macOS are connected. Shortcuts are iClouded, right? So if I was to go in my camera roll here, and select on that exact same video file there. It's playing, but I just have it muted. We're not going to have that keep playing. If I click on the share sheet and scroll down, it says bust out right there on the screen. Ooh, that's the wrong one. Cancel that. If I scroll up a little bit, it says bust out right there on the share sheet. So if I press it, it's going to ask me where I want to save this clip, and I'm saving it into a folder in the Files app called Audio Clips. So I go ahead and press that. And then if I navigate over to that on my Finder, turn up the volume.
A few moments later.
See, there you go. So super easy, super handy. Look, I can even show you from a random video of me doing something stupid. Let's see, where's a good one? Okay, this was from a recent event, and my buddy Kat is talking. I can click on the share sheet and then scroll down to the bust out. I tap it. It's going to prepare that. It needs to pull that from iCloud because that video is on iCloud real quick. And then I just go ahead and say open. And then when I click over to the file menu, there is that clip.
I'm going to do this week. Is this actually going well? Do I need to make...
Okay, I don't want to play all the cat's class out loud here on the internet, but it's just that simple. And look, you can even use it for cool stuff. Like I needed the that was easy file from the easy button, so I could do this.
That was easy.
There you go. So that's how I stripped the audio in order to make that. At a later date, I'll teach you how I made that little overlay, but very easy to do. And so to continue this making videos in order to help out creators just make cool stuff, I will be continuing to make these daily videos with little tips that can help you save time, save some money. Because I said this in my last series, Nice to Know, Nice to Have November. It's all about building little systems, and system is save yourself time, stress, energy, and money. System. Stress, time, energy, and money. Man, he can't even spell. So I want to give you tools that can help you create faster and just really start to enjoy this life so you don't get stressed out trying to figure out how to do all the do. So if you haven't done so already, pop that button down there below, because I am trying to get to 20,000 by the end of the year, and I'm going to do it by helping as many creators as possible create better stuff. Super simple. This and all the videos in this and the upcoming series will be sponsored by me. I am Doc. I am the creator of Doc Pops. I make these really cool acoustic foam mic covers that you can pop onto a mic and make yourself sound nice. My mic sounds nice. Check one. If you want to find out more about Doc Pops, check out DocPops.com, or you can head over to the merch site at DocMerch.com and just grab yourself a Doc Pop. You might as well look fresh and sound fresh at the same time. Now, right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should check out, and I absolutely agree with them. Go ahead, click it.